Right, hiya guys, and welcome back to the Lolo Masterfast My Team Career Mode, or whatever you would like to call it. Now, before we get into things, as you may have seen on Twitter, I had a serious issue with the game last week where I was recording this very race, the USA Grand Prix, recorded it fine, then the game crashed, I went back onto the game, it had lost all my data, and it was at Mexico, but none of the results stood from USA. So it was, I was like, that's really weird. I then clicked on to just think, right, we'll just have to jump USA, explain what happened, and do Mexico. And as I clicked on Mexico, the game crashed again, and then I lost absolutely everything. The game started from scratch, effectively. So I had to put all my name in, all the data in again, and yeah, so I was pretty much bummed at that point and was like, right, we're going to cancel the championship. We're going to cancel it because there's nothing I can do. Dave, F1 Games, PlayStation, the absolute legend that he is, he was like, no, stay at it, keep going. He was trying to recommend everything. He's never seen anything like this before. And he said it's just so bizarre that it won't go back to a previous save, even though the USA save was corrupted. Yeah, so it was a crazy, crazy thing. So yeah, there's been a lot of changes to the championship because obviously I've had to fast forward all the way through and get back to round 19 again. Here's all the driver changes. We didn't have any of those last time, and now we have. I've tried to keep the championship as close as possible. The only thing that I can emulate is the fact that I scored 79 points and my new teammate, Callum Ilott now, because we couldn't get Nick De Vries as he went to AlphaTauri. I've made sure he scores one. So as a team, we're still on 80 points, but we're massively underdeveloped compared to where we were at this point last week because it's been a whole new game. I've had to skip races, simulate sessions, simulate the races, and just do what I can. I've tried to fix the championship to get it close at the top, but then all the drivers moved around, and then it was horrendous. So yeah, you've got the likes of Bottas at AlphaTauri, Raikkonen at Red Bull, Vettel at McLaren, Vettel at Mercedes, then you've got Verstappen at Ferrari. It's just all over the place. But nonetheless, I won't be broken. Thank you so much, Dave, for the support with this. Over an hour he was trying to fix it for me. And here we go. This is the qualifying session now. And as you can see, we're up by about a second on our previous lap time using all the track and then some. And that is only going to put us in 19th position. So as you can see, we're well off the pace. It's just going to be a case of getting this first season over and done with now, to be honest with you. But like I said, a lot of driver changes, so bear in mind with that, I might get some drivers wrong, because this is the first race I've actually properly done on the game now, with all the new changes. But nonetheless, we're going to go into the race now. I'm going to hand you all over to the incapable hands of David Croft once again, and thank you so much for the support with this series. I'm down, but I'm not out.
Here we are then in one of the fastest growing cities in the United States, the fabulous Austin in the great state of Texas. The circuit itself, 14 miles southeast of the city center and home to the US Grand Prix since 2012. The latest in a long list of iconic tracks to have that honor. We're racing today then in Travis County, Texas, around the 20 corners of the wonderful Circuit of the Americas. We'll be reaching speeds of around 200 miles an hour, and there are plenty of good opportunities to pass, especially through the two DRS zones into turn one and the very long back straight into turn 12. Joining us today to oversee all the thrills and spills, it's Anthony Davidson. And great to see you. How are you feeling about the race today, and how are the circuit conditions from what you've seen?
Well, it's looking a bit cold out there, if I'm honest. These tyres have quite a narrow operating window in terms of the temperatures they need to extract the best grip. So with a cold track surface, it's going to be harder to keep those temperatures up, which will lead to lower grip and maybe more mistakes.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Vettel, Charles Leclerc and Albon. Sainz, Raikkonen, Ricciardo and Esteban Ocon. Bottas, Stroll, Pierre Gasly and Grosjean. Giovinazzi, Kvyat, Kevin Magnussen and the scientist. Russell, Ilott, Latifi and Nick De Vries. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
So as we wait for the five lights to go out on the... Oh, last season's career mode. We say go, go, bloody well go. And it's away we go from 18th place on the grid after Nyck de Vries's penalty. We've got Danica V out there squeezing us against the wall there. But no, no, we're not having none of it. And here we go, lads. Thanks for the gap. We're just going to take it all. Thank you very much. We get through on Kimi Raikkonen there in the Red Bull. But no, no, we have to give that one back. Naughty, naughty, because in the corner. And that is Valtteri Bottas in the AlphaTauri. I got him to lead in the championship with going through all the races again, just as he were. And then he's thought, sod it, I'm going to go to AlphaTauri. So there you go. What can we do, eh? But nonetheless, we are in P9 at the moment. We've got Valtteri Bottas behind us. We've got Kimi Raikkonen ahead as we run a little bit wide there and then cut that little bit of corner there. And we're just trying to see if we can maintain this ninth position as we run incredibly wide. Yeah, I'm learning that the brakes aren't as good on this Lolo Masterfast 2.0. As Dave mentioned as well, F1 Games PlayStation, I'm going to be mentioning him a lot because obviously he's the guy that made me carry on with this series. But like he said, the game is trying everything to stop Lola from finishing a career mode and ever getting beyond a season. So yeah, thanks a lot, Dave, for that. It's just been a crazy couple of weeks trying to sort this out. It's been absolutely mad. But we're back from the ashes, so to speak. And here we are in P9 now. Raikkonen ahead, Bottas behind. The two drivers that have changed positions. There's been a lot of changes this season. We're cutting that corner, but it was well worth it. We get a warning, but who cares? We're on the outside of Kimi. Come on, Kimi, get out of the way. We've suddenly found pace now. We cut corners. Got the overtake button enabled, still in rich mix of course as we complete the first lap, and now going into lap two, turn one, it's going to be maximum attack. We're lunging it up the inside of Kimi in that Red Bull, and we're through, but of course he gets the switch back and we're back down to P9. And yeah, here we are. We're going to be staying here for quite a while, I think, at this rate, because we don't seem to have the pace for anywhere else at the moment. We're just nice and happy in P9. We can maybe have a nibble on the back of Raikkonen, but only when an opportunity presents itself. The key thing is going to be to try and stay in the DRS range of him. Otherwise, we're going to be a sitting duck for the cars behind then at that point, and it's not going to be very good at all. So as we just come round the hairpin now, as we start the extraordinarily long straight, but nothing happening at the moment. We're just within this sort of range at the moment, on the cusp of the final top 10 points paying positions for now. And here we are, look, jumping all the way to lap 8 because we've not done anything. Too fast for Bottas, not fast enough for Raikkonen. We stay P9, but we run wide here, just going through and starting the second sector. That's going to send Bottas round the outside, and through he goes in that AlphaTauri. So we've got to be mindful of that. We're going to see if we can gain that position back. A couple of cars have stopped, so we're still in P9, but overall this will put us down into P10, and through we go. A little bit of contact there, wheel banging, and much love. And we get the DRS on Bottas for good measure, and a warning for the collision as well. Well, sorry Bottas, but we had to do what was right there. We're fighting for every points paying position at the moment. I don't think we're going to ever get a top 10 or a top 5 regularly and easily again with these last few races left to go. But we run wide there once again, but not to worry. We're all okay on lap 8, and it's going to be box this lap for us. Box this lap. We've confirmed to the team that we want to stop this lap, and we're going to go onto the yellow walled medium tyres. And see how well the lads can do there as we come around the final sector now. The opposites, they've tried to mimic Istanbul with this corner, didn't they? But it just didn't quite work. It didn't have the same atmosphere and flow to it. But nonetheless, we run wide there. But it doesn't matter because we're coming into the pits now to box this lap. We almost tagged the wall there on entry. That was very, very close. And in we come to the pit lane now. And as you can see, the tyres were just over 50% worn on the front left there. So yeah, it was time to change. Let's see where we come out. A few more cars in the pits as well. So it's going to be interesting to see if we can get the jump on anyone. Anyone need any wing repairs at all or anything like that? Well, Raikkonen's out ahead of us, so we haven't managed to stop him. A solid stop there once again by the Lola boys. 2.3 seconds, and that's Daniel Ricciardo through on us, is it? No, absolutely not. Get out of the way, Daniel. Come on. Can't turn in there, pal. We're coming out the pit lane. We get priority. Come on. Give way to the right. And nonetheless, we are marching through now, starting lap 9 of 14 in P10. I believe we've still got one car ahead to make their pit stop, and then we will be back into our P9 position. So we didn't gain anything, but we didn't lose anything either. Bottas looks to be a big loser out of all that, though, because Ricciardo and Ocon are through into 11th and 12th places now. So yeah, we'll have to see what happens there. But yeah, for now, we are P10 on lap 9. So as we jump forward now to lap 12, as you can see, we've got Lance Stroll behind us for the company now. As it looks like Valtteri Bottas has retired at the side of the track. That's where you can see the brief yellow flags there for on the corner of the minimap just going round. So yeah, shame for Bottas. He was on for a good result there, chasing us down. And we are currently in 9th position still. But there is Lance Stroll trying to take that 9th place off us. And he is saying, no, 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 I want 9th place, please. And he's made contact with us. He's actually hit us. Well, bit rough and ready there, Lance. And we are through and maintaining P9 for now down the long straight. But what's going to happen here? We seem to have another car for company as well. It's Esteban Ocon. We've got Stroll to the left of us. Ocon to the right. Here I am, stuck in the middle of you. And we managed to maintain P9 for now. Wow, oh wow. And just a little bit later into lap 9, Stroll gets past us because we're going incredibly wide. But we have our revenge on the contact from earlier in that lap. And we send him flying. And we're back through. Lance actually peels off into the pit lane. And we've got yellow flags now. And a warning for Ocon. What could that be for? Why have we got a warning? Let's have a look at a replay. On board with Ocon here. Or we're certainly focusing on Ocon. And he tries to make a move up the inside. Tags our rear wheel and straight into the pit wall. Front wing gone. And a possible retirement by the looks of things. But I'm not quite sure why we got a warning. That wasn't our fault at all. But nonetheless, we're on to the last lap now. The final lap. We've got Roman Grosjean for company, actually. He's followed by Danica Viat in the AlphaTauri. Have to remember that he's in a different car. Sorry, he's not in the AlphaTauri. What's he in? He's in the Alfa Romeo. There we go. I knew I'd get it at some point. Like I said, these driver changes have been crazy to try and keep up with. We're running incredibly wide. Ocon's only just been announced as out of the session and is qualified. And Grosjean tried to go for a move for us there. We make a little bit of contact with him, and that means that he slips down back behind Kvyat in the Alfa Romeo. And yeah, that means that we are still in P9 for now, but we're incredibly low on fuel. Well, we're not low, but we just not got any. It's just zero. So we're going to have to take and keep an eye on that. It looks like we definitely are going to have to. But Danica Viat makes no attack or attempt to get in past us here. But we're running incredibly wide there. We lose a lot of time. And it's just these medium tyres I'm really struggling with at the moment. It must be said. Running wide once again. Just can't seem to get it turned in. Come on, you tub of shit. Come on. I know the development's not as good as it were before. But we really are slipping back. More time lost there. More time lost. We're going to have Kvyat absolutely hounding us at this rate. So we're going to go around this corner. Well, we do that okay, but I think it's because we lost a lot of speed. Running wide once again there. That's going to allow Kvyat up the inside of us. Get back, you bugger. Get back. Get back. Get back. We're ramming him now. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Oh, no. The engine's coughing. The engine was coughing over the line. And we are in P10. Well done to Danica Viat there for getting from P11 to P9 on that final lap of that race in the Alfa Romeo. And we still get driver of the day, but I don't think it was deserved. But we pick up a point. And I'm happy with that. To say all the amount of stuff I've had to go through to get back to where I was, and the amount or the lack of development that has on this car compared to where we were last time, I'm pleased with the point. I'll be satisfied with that. But just a shame that Kvyat got us at the end there, and it was because the engine started coughing because I was out of fuel. So yeah, it was more crucial than I thought it was. It went into low fuel mode and it started spluttering at me. But nonetheless, the Mercedes boys incredibly happy. Who's that? That's Max Verstappen at Ferrari now, of course. He finished P4 just outside the podium. That's Sergio Perez at McLaren. And there is, there's Sebastian Vettel at Mercedes. Never thought we'd see that, would we? So there you go. Lewis Hamilton lifts the trophy a high. And it's time for the champagne! there you go. It was Hamilton from Perez, from Vettel, from Verstappen, from Leclerc, and we finished in P10. And we're P8 in the Drivers' Championship now as Sergio Perez overtakes us, so we've lost a place. And we've lost a place in the Constructors. We are in 7th now, which is where we were before in the standings. So, in some respects, I'm quite glad McLaren overtook us there, because I think we deserve P7. Although, AlphaTauri looking slightly devilish there in P8, maybe an outside chance with these last few races left if they can get their shizer together. Interesting fact as well, AlphaTauri didn't score a single point until after Hungary, which was when Bottas joined the team. So yeah, not a single point for AlphaTauri for the first 12 races. How mental is that? But then when AlphaTauri got Valtteri Bottas, then there you go, it was away and gone. So there you go, guys. We're going to renew our sponsorship for another 88 days. Thank you so much for watching. And thank you so much for the support. We're going to get this season over and done with now. But don't expect any startling results, as you saw there. We are struggling at times. But yeah, nonetheless, guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Dave, for the support and making me carry on and do this. It was a slog, but it was definitely worth it. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. And much love.